Hello, my people. Welcome back. It's your girl, Heather Anderson, here from Greater Faith Ministries International. Let me fix this a little bit. Okay. So I am back with your weekly encouragement. It has been a minute, a couple of weeks, but we had our Spiritual Awakening Conference and it was absolutely phenomenal. Want to thank Minister Kevin and Deidre Ewing and Minister Joelle and Sherilyn Ross for their awesome, awesome teachings on spiritual warfare. And of course, I cannot not thank my husband, Pastor Frank Anderson, for being a visionary for these conferences and just being obedient to the word of the Lord. And so I was gone for a couple of weeks, and so we did not finish the Spirit of Offense. Last video, if I can recall correctly, we talked about protecting ourselves and protecting yourself from the spirit of offense. And so on the last video, we talked about choosing your friends, choosing your circle wisely, because those that have influence on you can impact your walk, your life. And when something goes wrong and you are offended, especially by those that are close to you, it will impact you. And so we talked about choosing your circle wisely. This video, and I believe it's going to be the last, I think it's 12. I have 12 written down here, but it may be 11. And so we may have one more. But at any rate, this week we want to talk about keeping a clear conscience. And this is, again, protecting yourself, defending, or not even defending, but protecting yourself from the spirit of offense. And so we want to talk about keeping a clear conscience. If you haven't been tuning in, you want to go back to number one, where we talked about the spirit of offense, and we talked about how to, some good nuggets on when you're dealing with it. And now we're talking about how to protect yourself from getting into that, from allowing that spirit to lead you into and down this path of being offended and keeping unforgiveness, because at the end of the day, that's what it's going to produce, is unforgiveness and all of those things that come with that. And you don't want to open those doors. And so this week we're talking about keep a clear conscience. And again, we're not up here for a long time. This is to encourage you when you wake up or when you're going about your day and you need some encouragement and a quick fix. You can log in, dial into our channel, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell so that you can have an encouragement during the week. David said he had to encourage himself. And so a lot of these things that I have done to encourage myself, I want to encourage you. And so a way that we can keep ourselves from being offended is keeping a clear conscience. And let's look at what Apostle Paul said. And I'm going to take you to Acts 24 and 16. And I'm going to read this out of the Amplified. And 24 and 16 in the book of Acts says, "Therefore, I always exercise and discipline myself, mortifying my body, deadening my carnal affections, bodily appetites, and worldly desires, endeavoring in all respects." That's in the parentheses in that scripture because Paul wanted to break it down to us and what that means. But he says to have a clear conscience, void of offense toward God and toward men. Paul endeavored to keep his conscience clear because keep his conscience clear before God and man. He diligently kept his flesh under control of his spirit by disciplining himself in spiritual things. Paul disciplined himself in spiritual things. And if you are going to keep a clear conscience, you have to be disciplined and disciplining your flesh. So when people say things that you don't agree with, or they say things that may offend you, instead of being quick to speak, you want to be prayerful and discipline your flesh. If you're thinking the wrong thing about all the things that you could say to them or you should have said to them after you've walked away, of course, you know, we walk away and say, "Man, I should have said this, or I should have said that. How dare them do that and do this?" The Bible says that you need to keep a clear conscience before God and before men. And so how do you do that? You want to stay prayerful and make sure that you discipline your flesh. One of the things in disciplining your flesh, a lifestyle of fasting will work. A lifestyle of prayer will work. A lifestyle of studying your word will work. And so these are just a couple of things that you can do to discipline your flesh. Because when you go into the word and when you measure your life to the word, when you measure your life to the word, then you will begin to discipline that flesh and do what God has called you to do and get in alignment with the word instead of trying to put the word in alignment with you. Because God said, in the beginning was the word, and the word was God, John 1, and the word was with God. It didn't say in the beginning was the word and it was with you and you was the word. And so you have to bring your life in alignment with God's word to discipline your flesh. The Bible says also that some things just come out by fasting and prayer. That should be a lifestyle. We should not be fasting. A lot of churches do this at the beginning of the year. We do it too, 21 days, but that's a corporate fast. It should not be the only time of the year that you're fasting. Your fast should be a lifestyle. And so here are some things that will help you to get your flesh under control. You want a lifestyle of fasting and prayer. You want a lifestyle of studying your word, not reading it only, but studying it. When you study your word, the Bible says that we should meditate on the word day and night. That means that you read a verse or you read a passage and you meditate on it. You think on it. You apply it. You ask God, how can I apply this to my life? How can I do what you've called me to do based upon this scripture? You are studying. You are meditating on the word day and night. If anything can help you to control your flesh, the word can. Prayer will, and fasting and praying will. So Paul kept a clear conscience, okay? He endeavored to keep his conscience clear and diligently did that so that he can turn over his flesh to the spirit, so to speak. So his spirit was in control and not his flesh. And like Paul, we can develop ourselves to instantly recognize and avoid things that cause us to sin and grieve the heart of God. And so when you recognize that the spirit of offense is trying to creep in, you can quickly relieve yourself of that situation by not becoming easily offended, but being quick to forgive and quick to listen. Don't listen. I think I said this in one of the other videos. When someone is talking to you, or even if you are having a disagreement, it is important not to listen to respond, but listen to comprehend, listen to articulate what that person is trying to get across to you versus letting that defense mechanism build up. And then when that person finished talking, you want to quickly go in and respond to what they said. You weren't really listening. You were listening to respond and not listening to understand. So if you want to quickly turn yourself away from and guard yourself away from the spirit of offense, you need to listen to understand so that things would work better and you can use wisdom in your response. We can get to the place, listen to this, we can get to the place when we hear something ungodly, such as gossip or slander, or an alarm will go off in our spirit wanting us not to listen. As we train ourselves in the word, we'll become spiritually sensitive. And if someone says something that we shouldn't listen to, we will know to caution ourselves before we get into that. And so you don't want to put yourself in a position to listen to people that are gossiping or talking about someone else, because that same person who's bringing that information to you will bring some information to the other person. So you want to quickly shut that down, because here is what's going to happen. What is happening is you think that this person is being transparent and being honest and getting close with you by giving you this information, and it's all to get that same level of information out of you. And when that person does something to offend you, now you're hurt because you've shared some things with this this person. And so now you're operating, you allow the spirit of offense to come in and take root because you being close to this person. And we talked about this in another video, that those that are closest to you will offend you. How do you deal with that? You have to keep a clear conscience and understand that there's a spirit behind everything that is going on, whether the person is acting a certain kind of way, they said something, they're not doing what they would usually do, this is out of their character. You got to identify the spirit and not fight against the person. And to do that, you cannot let the spirit of offense to come in. To avoid the sin of offense, there will be opportunities. Trust me, there will be opportunities that you will be offended, and it will arise at busy times. It can arise when things are going on at work, or you have a deadline to meet something. It can be around holidays and people are all over the place and they're saying things that they shouldn't be saying. And you're like, wait, did you just say that? And so there are busy times when the spirit of offense will come in, and you have to remember to keep a clear conscience. James 4:7 says this: submit yourselves therefore to God, resist the devil and he will flee from you. This is not saying the devil, it has a small d here, is talking about those things that the enemy will bring to you, like the spirit of offense. Resist it and it will flee from you. When you yield to offense, you are yielding to the enemy's influence, and you certainly don't have him on the run. Instead, he'll have you on the run if you yield to his influence. And when I'm talking about his influence, I mean that the enemy influences people to do things to you or to say things to you. And when you operate in a spirit of offense, you yield to that influence. That means you respond to it contrary to the word of God and how God wants you to respond to it. So if you don't flee from it, the Bible says in James 4:7, and submit yourselves therefore to God, resist the devil and he will flee from you. If you don't resist him, then that influence will become will work your nerve, and then you would get into that spirit of offense or welcome that spirit of offense to you. If you build a good defense mechanism, resisting the devil and refusing to become offended, now you are yielding to God's influence. See, it's easy to say, I'm not easily offended. That doesn't bother me. It's easy to say that until something happens, and then you have to work that word. And so when you refuse to be offended, even it doesn't say that you can't acknowledge it. When someone has offended you, yes, you may acknowledge it to yourself. That person just said something that didn't sit right with me. But what do you do after that? You have to know that you are not going to be offended, and you have to decide that you are not going to be offended, and you have to refuse to become offended. So you can't refuse. You can't wake up in the morning and say, I choose not to be offended today. You can say that, but then when it happens, will you remember that? So acknowledging that person offended you, saying, you know what, God, this thing didn't sit right with me. I don't like the way she said it. I don't like what she said. I'm offended. You can then at that point refuse to be offended. Forgive that person. And if you need to talk to them to say, hey, this is what you just said, and this is how I felt about that, can we talk about this, so that you can get that straight with them and let it in right there, then that's what you have to do. But if you don't do that, you have to within yourself refuse to be offended. And when you refuse that, then you yield to God's influence. You allow God to fight your battle, because the Bible says that this battle is not ours, but it belongs to the Lord. So you will allow him to fight your battle by yielding into his influence, which is, I love you with the love of the Lord. And you got to get these, you can't think that you're so strong and you're this like spiritual superhero where nothing bothers you and you never get offended. You have to confess your faults, deal with the fact that this person offended you, but you need to yield your influence, yield yourself to the influence of God. The Bible says when you do that, that when you yield to God's influence, the enemy will flee. And so we have to purpose in our heart that we are not going to let the spirit of offense come in and reside with us, because we got too much to lose. You got too much going on. God has a promise for you. He said in Jeremiah 29:11 that he knows the things that he has for you. And it is, he has a plan for your life, a purpose, and an expected end. So God expects us to end well. So you cannot afford for the spirit of offense to come in and abort what God has expected from you, even from now. Because remember, he sees the end from the beginning. We're the only one that don't know the transportation that God is going to put us in or on to get us to that expected end. But the promise is he has an expected end for you. So I want to encourage you this week to know that God has a plan for your life. He has known you before you were even shaped in your mother's womb, and he has a plan for your ministry, for your life. Every person that comes in your life comes for a reason. God does not waste an experience. You will see the blessing of the Lord over your life if you decide not to be offended. Do not let the spirit of offense move in with you, because it will stagnate you from doing what the Lord told you to do. Why? Because as I said in another video, it does not come by itself. That spirit comes with friends, friends of unforgiveness. You might have some hate. Then you're going to, you'll be talking about people, and you will be offending people, causing your brother to stumble. There are several spirits that that spirit brings with it when it wants to move into your house. Don't let the spirit of offense move in. That is what I want to tell you today, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. I'm going to pray for you. If you are watching this video for the first time and you have not received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'm going to pray with you as well, because I don't want to take it for granted that only saved folks are looking at this video. We have enough unbelievers to go around, and my passion and my assignment is to bring the lost back to Jesus. Our assignment, according to the word of God, is to reconcile the lost. Reconciliation means that we were once with God and we strayed away. And so our assignment is to reconcile the lost back to the Lord. So I'm going to pray for you today. Subscribe to our channel. Hit that bell so you can know when we're on. If you want to visit with us, we are at One Park Lane in Douglasville, Pennsylvania, Greater Faith Ministries International, where our pastor is Pastor Frank Anderson. If you are not saved, say this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. Come into my life. Forgive me of my sins that I've committed against you. Come into my life. I accept you in my life. According to your word, I believe in my heart and I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and that you died for me and God raised you from the dead for my sins. Thank you, Father, for saving me. I am saved. God bless you. If you said that prayer for the first time, get into a Bible teaching ministry so that you can grow in the things of the Lord. Let me pray with all of you before we skedaddle out of here. Father, I thank you for your word tonight. I praise you, God, for a word of encouragement on how to protect ourselves from the spirit of offense. I pray, Father, that those that are listening to this video will be encouraged and will understand, Father, according to your word, that you and you alone will help them take control of their flesh, put their flesh under subjection, Father God, so that they might flee from the things that is acquiring them. Father, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you will give them the know-how and the wherewithal to stand against the things of the enemy with your word, the sword of the spirit. I pray, God, that you will show them how to dress themselves in the full armor of God and carry that sword of the spirit, which is the word of God, to combat every enemy and every demon that is soliciting them right now. I pray, God, that your people will begin to put their flesh under control by living a lifestyle of fasting and prayer and studying of your word, Father. And I I thank you, God, that you and you alone will bring them out on the other side. You will bring them, hallelujah, to the place that you have predestined for them, because you promise in your word that you have a hope for them and an expected end. I pray, God, that their expectations will grow in the things of God, that they will believe you when you say, when they read your word, they will believe what you say, Father, because you said that your word will not return to you void, but it will do everything that you've sent it out to accomplish. And so, God, I pray for the increase of faith for your people right now to understand that if you said it, it shall be so. I pray, God, that you will keep them, and those that are dealing with the spirit of offense, I pray that they will quickly repent, Father. Ask for forgiveness where forgiveness needs to be given. I pray, God, that there will be some reconciliation with relationships, Lord, and I pray that you will free your people now from the spirit of offense. It is in Jesus Christ's name of Nazareth that I pray. Amen and amen. Fam, it's been so good being back with you tonight. We will see you next week with the last spirit of offense encouragement, and then we are going into the spirit of rebellion. And so you don't want to miss out on this, because people need to be free, and the spirit of rebellion is no joke, and that will definitely put a halt in your ministry and in your walk with God if you are not being obedient to the things of God. I am so excited about that teaching. Well, I love you with the love of the Lord, and keep us in prayer, and we will see you soon. God bless.